On the Medical Watch tonight, pneumonia and COVID-19.
And medical reporter Dina Bear is here with the latest findings.
Pneumonia is an infection of the air sacs in the lungs, typically caused by a bug, bacteria, or influenza, and now SARS-CoV-2. But doctors say the virus leaves more severe damage in its wake, and now they believe they know why, knowledge that will lead to better treatments.
I think it's still not widely understood that at its heart, severe COVID-19 is pneumonia.
Dr. Benjamin Singer knows pneumonia. He's been studying it for years. But with COVID-19, it's different.
What we found is that the immune system responds to the pneumonia caused by COVID-19 in a different way than it responds to patients with pneumonia caused by even another virus like influenza or due to bacteria.
The Northwestern Medicine pulmonologist and critical care doctor and his colleagues collected fluid samples from 86 COVID-19 patients on ventilators. They compared the samples to 256 ventilated patients with other types of pneumonia. Instead of rapidly infecting large regions of the lung like a more typical pneumonia, SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, takes hold in multiple small areas of the organ, infecting normal immune cells.
So the virus we found actually infects some of the normal immune cells that are in the lung called macrophages. And this is an unusual thing because when this virus infects those immune cells become very inflammatory and they can actually lead to lung damage themselves.
Think of it like a wildfire.
What we see in COVID-19 is more like the wildfires in the West where you have little embers that kind of pop up and then die out and spread to other areas and ignite in new areas over time.
And time is a major factor.
It may not be the severity of the inflammation at any one point, but because the disease lingers for so long over time, you're exposed to that inflammation over a much longer period of time than you might be with, say, that kind of hot fire that burns very hot and then dies out quickly. The disease itself won't go away, right? It's going to be with us for some time. And so finding better ways to help people, I think, is an important thing to do.
And that's the next step, testing drugs already in existence to see if they can tamp down the inflammatory response in immune cells. Northwestern hopes to start a clinical trial in the coming weeks. Back to you.